in between windows. Switching between windows. So the URL is this one, windows. Okay, now let me open this in Firefox. Right, so now directly you came to this particular switch to Windows frame. Now let us understand this one. So if you want to navigate here, I need to open this URL and then need to click on this tab, and then I will have a click button. After I clicking on the button, I will get two more windows, but this is not exactly window. This is the window. These are the two windows I will get here. Now I need to switch to this particular windows. Now let us try this with some example. Let me open this form. Now let me create a script, WebDriver commands. Now right click, new class, switching windows. Switching windows. Right, take the main method. So now let us go with as usual normal way, system.set property, driver object we need to create. So I'll copy paste it over here. And then we need to use a driver object. So what's the first thing we need to do here? We need to open this particular URL. So driver.get quotations URL, right? Now we need to click on this one. So let us understand this link or tab, whatever. Highlight this. This is an XPath. Take this driver.findElement by.XPath dot click. And then once you click on this, then you will get this click button. And then just a moment, guys. Okay, so now we need to click on the click button. Just a moment. Take the click button, copy this, and then driver.findElement by.XPath dot click. Okay, then once we click on this, multiple windows will be open. So actually, this is not the window, this one and this one. Let me click once again. Click. Right, so two windows will be open. This is the one window, this is another window. Now, once we click on this, two windows will be open. So currently, on which window driver will be focused? Parent window or child window? So this is a parent window. Still, the driver will be focused on the parent window only. So if you want to check what we can, how we can check, we can get the name of the page. driver.get title or current URL, or we can say also get title. So if I get this, so we will know on which driver, which page or which window it is focused on. So then let us print this system.out.println driver.get title, just for verification. So whether driver is focusing on the parent window or second window. Okay, so this is the first thing. So let us check first, then we proceed with the script. Now open the form. It opens the form. Just it opens the form, not clicked. What happens? Yes. Yeah. Just it's also open the second form. So this is the second form. Okay. Second window. So sometimes it will open the right side tab, or sometimes it will open the new window, but that doesn't matter actually. So in any case, the methods will work as usual. So now it will throw in frames.windows. The name, title of the page, it is displayed. So what does it mean? Currently it is focusing still on the parent window, not on the child window. Now I want to switch to child window, and then I want to get the title of the child window. Okay. Now how to switch to child window? How to switch to child window? So there is a command. First, before switching to the child window, we need to get some ID of that particular window. So every browser, let me show you one thing here. So every browser, so this is one window, this is one window, right? Internally, it will manage one ID. So ID is nothing but that is not HTML ID actually. So that is a bigger one, a string kind of stuff. So it is a collection of 10 to 12 letters will be there. That is basically called as a key also. Every window or every browser will have it. So we need to get that particular ID or key. So based on that, we can easily identify and switch, or we can switch to that particular window. That is the only way we can do it. So how we can get that particular ID? So before that, what we can do is, for example, if we want to switch to that one, let us see, we need to use a one method called driver.getWindowHandles. There is a method, getWindowHandles, driver.getWindowHandles. What this method will do is, it will return us how many windows are open, not how many actually, how many windows are open and their IDs it will return. So as I said, every browser or window having certain ID. So get window handles method will return us whichever, how many windows may be open, 1, 2, or 3, more than 3, that doesn't matter, but it will return us, it will give us information about the IDs about all the browsers. Okay. Now those IDs we can store in some variable. First thing. So now what kind of variable it should be now? We are storing multiple things here, right? So we need to use a set class. Set is another predefined class actually in Java. So that can be used for storing multiple things. And whatever it is returning, those values are string type values. So that we need to specify a casting here. That is called string casting. So set method will throw an error. So we need to import one package. So java.util package we need to import. Okay. So what does it have done here is, I'm capturing what are all windows are open. So those IDs I'm capturing first, and then I'll store those IDs in a variable called S. So this S contains all windows IDs. Now we need to read each and every ID, and then we can switch to that particular ID. So how we can read this? Suppose, let me write a for loop statement. For, let me take a string variable called I. I'm writing the enhanced for loop. Okay. String I colon yes. What happens now? So in yes, we have multiple strings now, right? So first it will take the first string value, and then it will store in I. Then it will store in I. So now I is contains the ID of the browser. So we need to switch to now. We need to switch to that particular browser. How we can do? driver.switch to dot window, and here we need to pass that ID, that is the value of I, and then dot get text. So after switching that particular window, just the get the title of the page. Okay, title of the page, and then after switching to this, what I can do is, let me we switch to that particular window, right? And then we have getting the title. So store the title value in some string here, or key is equal to, and then print the title. System dot. Later, next example, we will see how to close that particular window based upon some conditions. Okay, so let us, as a first step, let us understand how many windows are opening and how to get the IDs of those windows. And then we will see how to switch it. So system dot, how to dot, println, I'm printing the value of the window. Just observe this one, what it will do is. So first, whenever I click on the link, this is the title of the page. Let me comment this one. So whenever I switch, whenever I use this method driver.getWindowHandles, this will get IDs of the available windows or available browsers. So currently we have two browsers are available. So it will store the two values in the variable called s. Now s is contains two string type of variables. Now while I'll take the one variable, one value from s and store that value in the I, and then I'm switching to that particular window. So what I is window ID, right? So I need to switch to that particular window. I contains the window ID. So we need to specify directly the value of I. So window of I, after switching it, this will switch to that particular window. And then I'm getting the title of the page. So first it will switch to normal parent window. And then the loop is repeating, right? The second value you're having the second window. Now again, it will switch to second window. Then it will get the title of the second window. So this loop will get a returns the titles of the both the windows or both the browsers. This is a simple logic I have written. So basically this is a switching statement. If you want to switch to one browser to another browser, we need to know the ID of that particular browser. So if you want to print what it is contains, we can also print it, not a problem. So let me print this first. If you want to see, I can print that. So first let me execute this, then I will show you what the I value contains. Okay, now execute. Let me 1 second close all the stuff. Right now run as Java application. Now you observe it opens the page, click on the main window, and also it open the parent child window also. It is open, not this one, and this is a child window open. Now go to the script and see now the title of the first page or first window is frames and windows, and the title of the second page is this one. So two things are, that means it is switched between one window to another window. Okay, now let us understand what this value contains, what are the values get window handles are returned. So let us see that value. So let me, before that, let me print that one. System.out.println of I. Just I value, just print it. And let me comment this one. I'm not going to do this. Okay, now it should print two IDs, right? Those IDs will referring to the two browsers. Now execute. Again, this is the one window. Again, this is open the parent window and child window. Now both windows are open. Now come to the script. Now you see, this is the code. This is a basically some hexadecimal or some format it is there. So this format it will return. Okay, so based on this ID, we can switch to that particular window and we can do the whatever operations we want. Okay, so these are the values it will return actually. So get window handles returns the values or our key value of this particular windows that can be stored in a variable called s, which is a set. Set means it contains many values, and this is a string type, but all values are string type, so I define as a string type. Okay, fine. So I read the every value, and based upon that value I switch to. So first time it will switch to the main window, and second time loop is repeating, second time it will switch to the second window. Okay, right? So this is how we need to switch to one window to another window. Is it clear, both of you?
Yes.
Now we will see one more example. Now I have two different windows. I want to close whatever window I want. Okay, whichever. So I want to have two different windows, but I want to close the parent window, or I want to close the child window only. So this is also very important question in interview. How we can close a specific window, whichever window you want. So how we can close this? So let me enhance the same script again, little bit more. Here, what I'm doing, I'm switching to particular window. I'm getting the title, right? So here we can put one, let me remove this also. We'll put one condition here. So what is the condition? Suppose if t dot contains or equals. We can say t dot contains or equals t dot contains. Here I'll say title of the page. Suppose what is the title of the page that we need to specify. So on that particular window will be closed. Based on the title condition, we can close that particular window. So before closing the window, we need to know the title of the page. Title of the page. So which one we will close? Let us close the parent one. Okay. So what is the title of the parent one? Title of the parent one. Title of the parent one. The parent class, parent window title is frames and windows. Frames and windows. That is the title, right? Specify that value. And then if t dot contains this one, and then driver dot close. Close command will close only current window, right? There is a simple command we can use. So we have only one statement under this condition. We no need to put brackets, or else we can put the brackets. That is optional anyways. Okay. Now what happens? See, based upon the condition, we are closing that particular window. Okay. So if the page, so first it will get that, capture the first page and store that title in the T. Now if T dot contains or T dot equals also, you can use it. Title is this one, then close the particular browser. And then it will go and take the second browser, and it will switch to second browser, but it is condition is not matched. And then what happens? The browser still open. We are not closing that browser. We are browser still open. So this is the based on the condition, we can close appropriate browser. Now let us execute and see how it will execute. Just a moment, close this everything. Now execute. Now I'm going to close the parent one, then we will see the child one. Now run as Java application. Now it is open the parent window. Now it is a child window. Now see, as soon as it's open the child window, parent window has been closed. Parent window is not available. Only child window is still available. And now what we can do is, instead of this, we can also close the child window. So let us see the title of the child window. How to get the title of the child window? If you click and see view page source, and the top of the page, you can see title somewhere. So this is the title of the page. Okay. Copy this and paste it over here. Okay. So now what happens? If this title of the page is this one, and then close that particular window. Now it will close the child window. Let us see an example now. Close this. Run as Java application. See now, this is the parent window. Right? It opens the child window. It is opening the child window. Now child window has been closed. Still parent window is available. Okay. So this is how we need to switch to one window to another window, and then we can close that particular window. So after switching it, you can, whatever operations you want, you can do it. No problem. Okay. So this is how we need to do. So what is the method we need to get? Get window handles. This is an important method. Get window handles. Get window handles. How to use driver command? Driver dot driver is an object name. Okay, we don't need specify. So this will return as the returns. What it will returns? ID is not, this ID is not HTML ID actually. Okay, I shown you that bigger string value, right? So that is a key or ID. We can say key, ID or a key value of a browser. Browser or browser window. So based on this, what we will get? Based on this, we will store all IDs in some variable, and then we'll get the title of those pages. Based on that, we will switch to window based on that particular value. After switching to that particular window, then only we can get the title. Okay, so this is a simple example for switching between the frames. This is the only method we have. And then anyway, you know, close method and quick quit method, right? Close will close a specific browser. Quit method will close all existing browsers. These are the basically browser commands, browser related commands. Okay. Is it clear now? Switching between windows.
Yes.
Right. So now let us see. So with this, we have completed the WebDriver command. So what are all the different commands so far we discussed? Can you list out them, all those commands?
Switch between frames, switch between alerts and pop-ups.
From the beginning, what are all WebDriver commands we discussed so far? All WebDriver commands, list of all
get title, commands. Get text.
Right. Get title.
Get current URL.
Yes. Get current URL, get title. Those are get and methods, wait. Right?
And wait.
Yes, command. Wait methods, implicit wait and explicit wait. And then
explicit, yes. Navigation.
Right. Yes, navigation. Navigate.back, navigate.forward, navigated.navigation commands. And then finally switching commands.
Okay. Switching, yes.
Yes, switching commands. So these are all the different WebDriver commands. These are all called WebDriver commands. Okay. So you need to remember all the commands. That's the most important thing. So let me list out all the commands here. Okay, just a minute. So these are called browser commands.
We didn't do
and also, yes.
Do for checkbox and
I'll explain button, that right? Part. That is the next class actually. Now I'll coming to that part. We will deal with all the web type of elements. These are just commands I discussed. Okay. So next class, going further, we will discuss about how to interact with the elements, different kinds of elements, or checkboxes, radio buttons, text boxes, calendar control, list box, okay, web tables. There are many kinds of elements are there. A lot of things are there. So we need to interact with them. And also there also we will use different kinds of methods. Okay. So I'll discuss also that. No, don't worry. So
okay, how to switch between menu and submenu?
So menu and submenu, right? The same XPath, you can do it. I'll show you a simple example.
I was trying yesterday. Okay.
I'll show you just a minute. So these are the commands we discussed so far. Just I'm listing out here. Okay. And then these are the navigation commands. And finally, switch commands. These are the switch commands, right? These are called browser commands. Browser commands, and then these are conditional commands, and then these are the wait commands, and then these are get commands, and then these are navigation commands. Now these are the switching commands, right? Fine. So these are the different commands we discussed so far. All are very important. Okay, now let us go to window handles. Right, now let us try to interact with the multiple elements of web page. So usually if you go for any web page, so what are elements? You can see web elements. Everything is a web element. If you see a link, link is a web element. If you see a text box is a web element. Radio button is a web element. Image is a web element. Everything is a web element. Okay. So just can we tell you, can you tell me some common web elements which are present in the web page? Usually, what
like
are those things
box,
you can
see? Link.
Yes, web elements.
Tabs.
Yes, so text box, right? This is also called as input box. Text box is also called input box. And then button we can see, and link we can see.
Yes, button.
And then radio buttons and checkboxes and drop down or list box, or this is also called as combo box. And what else we required? We see iframes we already covered. Frames also actually, frame is a web element. Okay, frame is also a web element. But this we have covered with the switching commands. Okay, and then again we are not going to discuss
for
this.
Tab also.
Okay. Yes, tab is just like a link. It will comes under the link. I'll show you how we can do the tag. One example, then you can understand. Okay. and then web table. Web table is also an element.
Yes, web table.
And then calendar.
Drag and drop.
Sometimes you will see the date pickers, right? So sometimes you will get the calendar object, and calendar window you need to select the month and the date and everything, right? So that's called date picker. Yes. Calendar control. And then after that you will see the file upload, right? Uploading file.
Yes.
So that is the one kind of element. So these are all the common things we will see on the web pages, right?
Or
so if you want
download
to automate it, yes, download is also. Download is a simple one. This is a, like a button. That's it. If you click on the button, it will start automatic download. So
but
this
we
is
cannot,
a small, these are the small, yes.
But we cannot verify the download report, right?
No. Download, the file you cannot verify.
PDF?
So only you can check whether it is download option is working or not. That's it.
Okay.
After clicking on the download, you cannot verify the file. That you can verify manually. There is no other way. Okay. But still,
drag
you can verify
and drop
something
also
like, drag and drop. Yes, exactly. So drag and drop also there. Drag and drop. We can drag something and we can drop somewhere, right? Element, drag and drop elements. So these are all the different kinds of web elements. Most frequently, we can see these elements on the web page. Now, if you are trying to automate a test case, these kind of element you frequently see on the pages, right? So on that particular time, we need to know how we can handle this, how we can interact with these elements, right? So basically, let us understand what are all different actions we can do. For example, if I take text box or input box, what are all actions we do? If you see an input box, what are all different actions? We will enter some text, right? Just as a manual part I'm discussing, we will enter some text on the input box. That's it, right? So for entering a text, we have a method called sendKeys method, right? Similarly, yes, we have a button. So whenever we see button, what we are going to do on button, we will click on the button.
Click
is a method. And similarly, link is also available. So what we will do on the link, again, we do the click on the link. And radio buttons are there. We have two or more radio buttons. What we will do, we will select that particular radio button. So for that also, we need to use the same method, that is click method. For button, link, radio buttons, or checkboxes, all these things, we have only one method called click method. For selecting or unselecting, for both, we use a click method. Especially for radio buttons and checkboxes, select or unselect, whatever you want to do, we use a click method only. If I use click method, if you already selected, it will unselect. Suppose if it is not it is unselected state, if I use click method, then it will select. It will work for both the things, select as well as unselect. Okay, we will see some more examples on this. And then drop down or list box or combo box. So drop down means it contains many number of values or items. We can pick one value
select.
At a time. Say, right, that is a drop down. That is also called a list box and combo box. But sometimes we can select only one value at a time. In drop-down box, in the list box, we can select multiple values at a time. That is possible, but the method is same. All three things we will use on the same method. And then frame we discussed, right? A frame is nothing but a portion of the web page. So a web page contains many number of frames. If you want to perform certain actions on the frame, we need to switch to one frame to another frame. That we have seen. And then web table. Sometimes in the web pages, you will see the tables, right? So in the table, what are all operations we will do? On the tables, so how count number of rows and count number of columns and get the values from all the rows, right? Get the values from all the columns. These kind of operations we will do on the web table. And then calendar control. On the calendar, what are operations we can do on the calendar? We'll select the date, right? And then file upload, we know. And drag and drop, we'll select some actions from the right side, or we can drop those items in the left side, or we can drag the items from the left side and drop those options in the right side. So these are the different kinds of actions we can do. So for drag and drop, especially, we have a new class which we need to use, that is called actions class. So by using actions class, we can perform those operations. Okay, we will discuss that at the later point of time. Now let us see how we can interact these elements by using some example. Now I'll introduce one a new URL which contains all kinds of elements. So now let me open the URL, close this one. Now open this URL. So this form is created by me. Actually, I have created this form because this form contains all kinds of elements. Except that upload is there, except that web table element and drag and drop. Other than this, everything is present here. See now, name and cities, email address, phone or text boxes or input boxes. Text we can box. Use send case method. And if you see here, we can select only one value at a time. This is a drop down box. And these are the radio buttons. We can select only at a time one radio button, right? And here check boxes, we can select more than one value at a time. That is the radio buttons. And this is upload option. So if you want to upload this, this is very important one. This we cannot handle directly because if I click on the browse option, it will open up the window. So this is a window based application. Our web driver cannot handle window based applications. Our web driver can handle only web-based applications, not a window-based application. So this kind of operations here, what we need to do, we need to select some file. We need to select some file like this, and then we need to open. Then it will. So for example, I have some file, suppose here. So let me click on this open, select the file and click on open. Now the file is attached here. Okay, so this kind of operations we can perform by using AutoIT. AutoIT is a different concept. I will explain in the coming classes. Okay, and then select date. So if you click on this, sometimes what happens is we can enter directly date here by using send keys. But sometimes some real-time applications, they won't allow you enter the value there directly by using send keys. Then what you can do is you must specify the value in the calendar. There is no other way. You need to select the month or year, or year, or you can select the month, appropriate month, and then you need to select the date, then date will be displayed. So this is a different kind of calendar control. And this is the text area. This is also normally we can use the text area. This is a send keys method we can use. Normal text box, but this is a little bit bigger one. That's it. And then there are two links are here. If I click on this first link, it will go to some other page. Go back. If I click on some other link, it will go to another page. Okay, so these links also we can verify. So these are the basic elements we have listed out here. So how many elements we found here? We found text box, button is present. Button is nothing but a link only. So button is not separate one. If you see here in the same page, here there is a submit, right? This is also button. So button we have seen. Link is present, radio buttons present, checkbox is present, drop down list is present, and frame we discuss, but the frame is not available in this particular page, and web table is not present, file upload is present, and drag and drop. Only 1, 2, and 3. These are the three options are not present in this particular page. So apart from these three options, frame we already discussed, so I left this, and then web table is not there. And then drag and drop is not there. So what else is there? Frame is also not there, but frame we already discussed, right? So now we will discuss these elements for today. And then tomorrow I'll explain these two things. And also calendar control also I'll do tomorrow. Okay, it will take some time actually. Now let us, and file upload will also take one more class. These are the special kind of elements actually. So file upload will need to use AutoIT concept. Calendar we can use it directly, we can web driver we can use it and deal this element, and then web table also it will take one or two classes, and then drag and drop will take one more class. Okay, these are little bit very important and complex things. Okay, we need to use special kind of classes for them. And now today we will see these elements. Okay. These elements. Okay, next coming classes I will explain this. Now let us see today. I need to enter some values in all the stuff. Okay, let us see how we can do this. Let me automate this form. Close this. Let me web driver commands almost done. Now let me create a new package. So my new package name is handling web elements. Web elements. I'll cover all web elements in this particular package. Now create a new class. My class name is volunteer signup form. Volunteer signup. Form automation, right? So this is my page. Now let us see, as usual we need to put all the stuff, driver property and driver object we need to create. So put that value and done. Now we need to open the URL. driver.get. What is the URL? This is my URL. This is a full URL. If you want to get the shortcut URL, I'll copy that URL in your text here. So this is my URL. Sorry, not this one. Let me copy this. This is my URL. Volunteer sign up form. This will also open the same page. Shortcut link. Okay. This is a URL today I explained, right? So this is another URL. So this page I can put here. Done. Now it will open the page. Now we need to deal with each and every element. So let us go for Firebug. Let us understand properties of these elements. Let us take the first one. What it is contains, what are the properties? It contains a name, text field, something else, right? So IDs we have. Let us take ID value. So driver dot find element by dot ID and specify the ID value dot send keys. There we need to enter the name, right? Send keys and then city. Similarly, again driver dot find element by dot ID. So we need to get the value of ID, right? So let us go and check the ID for city. For city, what is an ID? Result text field iPhone 3. So this is my ID. So you put this ID here. Dot, this is also send keys. So what is this? This is the ID, right? So fine, city. And then email address. Select that email address. What is the ID of email address? This is the email address ID. So now let us see driver dot find element by dot ID. So here specify that ID dot send keys dot send keys. And here we need to say email ID. Done. So now we have entered the event. Next one is a phone. So take this and ID of the phone is this one. Now driver dot find element by dot ID. Specify the ID value here dot send keys. So here phone number, suppose some numeric value it's in the course. Fine. So now we entered all the values in four text boxes. Name, city, email address, and the phone. So I'll write here name, city, email, and phone. Done. Now coming back to this one. This is a drop down box, right? So how to handle drop down box? This is an important one. So if you want to deal with the drop down box, we need to use a special class called as select class. Select class, that is more important. Okay. So now let us understand select. So first what we need to do is, this is an element again, right? So it contains many elements. These are also web elements. All three, these are also web elements. Okay. Now select, for example, what is the drop down list user? Time to contact, right? So let us see time DRP time drop down. So equal to new select. This is how we need to create the object for select, right? So what we need to pass here is we need to pass a web element, the web element address, the complete web element we need to pass. So before that, what we need to do is get this one. And what is the ID of this? This is the ID of the drop down box. Let us try to understand this object, identify that object, driver dot find element by dot ID. So this is the ID of the drop down box. Just identify this. That's it. I don't do any perform operations. Any operations I didn't perform. Just identify that element. Store that element in some variable. Store that element some variable. So what is the variable? For example, DRP time. So this is the variable. This is the variable. And what type of should variable this one? We are storing the web element in a variable. So what type of it is? What type it is? It is also
string
element.
No, the web element. Okay.
Not string. Okay. Web element type. Okay. So we need to import appropriate package. So this is a web element type because we have captured the web element completely and then store that web element here. Now this web element we need to pass to the select class. because only not on this is the purpose of this is only identify the web element. But what is our action actually? We need to select some value from the drop down, right? So for that reason, we need to use the select class. So which we need to import one special package. So select class will be available on multiple packages, but you need to import the correct package. Otherwise, you will get the issues. So org.openqa.selenium.support.ui. This is the only package which we need to import for select. Now what happens? Drop down time. This element is pointing to the drop down object or element. Then from that element, I need to select some values, but it contains many values so that I have created a select class object. Now, if I want to select an element from the drop down box, what you need to do? See, put a simple name because already I used that name, you will confuse. Okay. Now, t dot, there are three different methods for selecting the value from a select box. We can use select by index, or we can use select by value, or we can use select by visible text. Okay. So, suppose if I use select by index value. So index is always start from the zero. From zero, there is no element at all. So 1, 2, 3, totally 0, 1, 2, 3 elements are there. So by index means we need to specify the index. This is a one. This is a by index value. Suppose if you want to see another method, select by value. What is the value? Where the value is present? Actually, whatever is appearing here, this is not a value actually. So value can be seen only in the HTML file. Suppose if you identify this element, extract this. So here you can see the value property. So this is exactly the value. Okay. Suppose if you want to select evening, what I should do now? I should copy this one. That is the value actually. So if you want to use value, you need to use this one. This is by value. Suppose you don't know the index and you don't know the value, then what you can see simply, this is a visible text, right? So in the visible text, you can also use t dot select by visible text. So whichever is visible, we can say, suppose evening is there. So now you can put directly evening. Okay, sometimes value and visible text both will be same sometimes. Okay, so don't confuse. So this is by visible text. So these are three different methods. You can use whichever method you want. But most of the times we don't know the index. We don't know the value. So most of the times we will use only visible text, because visible text means it is coming here, right? We are able to see the values here. That is why. Okay, this is a main option, right? So now let us see, let us execute and see till this. And because this is a new element, I told you, right? This is most important element. And also I will show the different things, different type of validations we can do on the select box or drop down box that I will show you. Now let us see it is able to select this element or not. Now run as Java application. See, now it is opening the form. Enter name, city. Now it is evening it is selected. Now there is one validation I want to perform here. I want to perform some time validation on the drop down box. So what is my validation here? My expectation is I should have three elements present in the drop down box. The drop down box, there should be three elements. Okay, there are three options should be present. That is my expectation, but that I mean to validate. How we will know whether how many options are present in this or not? How we will know? But if you see manually, if you have 3 or 4, we can easily identify. But if you have hundreds or thousand values are present in the drop down box, it is very difficult to check manually, right? So I want to validate number of elements present in the drop down box. As per the requirement says, suppose 10 elements are present. Suppose how we can validate that requirement? I need to verify exactly how many are there in the actual application, right? Then I need to compare. So how we can do this validation? There are some methods to count how many elements are present in the drop down box. There are some methods. So how we can do this? So let us see. I have created an object, right? I have created an object. So take this object. So this object contains many number of values, right? So click on the dot. We have a method called get options, there is a should be method actually, not get. Just a moment. Get attributes, insert, displayed, yes, not here. Okay, not here. After passing this, you need to take the t value. Because t value contains all the elements, right? All the web elements, we capture this one. So new select means drop down box we are passing. So t is a main, t contains all the elements now. Okay, by using t, we are selecting the element. So now we need to take the t value dot. There is a method called get options, get options. So what this method will do, this method will get all the options from the t. What is t here? T will represent the drop down box. So from the drop down box, it will get all the options. What are all those options? Everything is a web element again. Option means here web element. Get options means get web elements. But we don't want web elements. We want only the name of those web elements. I told you here one thing. In the drop down box, everything is a web element, right? Get options method, what this will do is you will get all the web elements. All these web elements it will capture. Okay, but after capturing those options, we can get the how many options are available by using size method. Now this will give us a number of items present in the drop down box, present in the drop down box. This is the method. So t dot, if you want to select a value, t dot select by visible text, we can do it. But if you want to get number of values are present on the drop down box, the same object we need to use, select object, t dot get options dot size, get options dot size. Get options will get the all the options, and the size method will count how many options are there. Is it clear? Are you able to follow? Now I'm printing the number of elements. So now system dot out dot println. Done. Now just it will give us the number, how many values are there in the drop down box. Now run as Java application. Again, it will open the form, enter all the details. It is done. Now coming to the console window, how many elements are there? It is saying four elements are there. Now if you come and see, there are only three elements because this is a space, right? So this is also considered as a one element actually. So considering this, it is saying four elements. Okay, so this is how we can count number of elements present in the drop down box. Is it clear? Any doubts on this? Drop down box is very important. I will also give some assignments on this. Is it clear? If you have any questions,
no.
Clear. You need to identify the element, store that element in some variable, and pass that variable to the select class object. And the same object we need to use for all the methods. Get to be select by visible text, or select by value, or select by index, whatever method we want. Among these three methods, you can use one method. Okay. Now we have done with the select box, drop down box. Now we go to the checkboxes. Now we have two checkboxes, both are unselected. Before selecting the checkboxes, I want to validate something. What is the validation here? I need to check whether the checkbox is enabled or disabled, or it is selected or not. First of all, it is selected. Suppose if it is selected, I want to unselect it. If it is already unselected, I want to select it. That is my validation. Okay, so suppose I selected this, I need to verify it is selected or not. That is my condition. If it is already selected, then if I click on again here, or something else, it will unselect. And if you click on this, this will be unselect. So the state will be changed. We can also get the states of this. It is selected or unselected. So what is the command we need to use here? Conditional commands. I told you before that, right? Is selected or not? Is selected method. right? So that method we need to use for checking the status of the radio button. It is selected or not. It will throw true or false. If suppose it says true, that means the radio button is selected. If it is says it returns a false, means it is not selected. That's the condition. Okay. Now let us deal with this. So by default, both are not selected. Both are not selected. So let me check the condition first. Before check the condition, what I should do now? I should get the XPath or ID of those elements. So let me say yes element. So what is the ID of this? This is the ID of yes radio button. Yes radio button. Now go to script. And now here, so continuation. Okay, these are the radio button now. Here radio button started. Radio button selection. So before that, I want to check the condition where the radio button is enabled or disabled or selected or unselected. So what I need to do now? I need to identify element first. Driver dot find element by dot ID. So you need to specify the ID value and then dot is selected. Selected, because this is a radio button, right? Is selected. Either it will return true or false. So now let me print that value. System dot out dot println. So this will print the status of the select box. Status of the select box. What it will return? Either true or false. But whenever I open this particular form, by default it is not selected. So that our expectation is it should return false. It should return false. Then I need to enter or I need to select that value. So which value we are going to select now? Let me select yes only. So how to select? Identify the same element. Same element means same.
Click
this one. Yes, same element dot, just a moment, driver dot find element, the same thing, take it dot click, sorry, by ID one more bracket dot click. Okay, this will click on the radio button. So now I have used yes button. So it will check yes button is selected or not. And it will return either true or false. And then it will set the radio button. So now this is done with the radio button selection. Okay, now come to the checkboxes. Checkboxes also very easy stuff. Let me open the form again. Same way we need to handle checkboxes also. Now, check radio buttons, we cannot select more than one, but if you come to the radio box checkboxes, we can select more than one checkbox. Suppose if you want to select the first three, so what I should do now? I need to capture the properties of first three now. So first take the first one, Sunday. So take this XPath of this, or name also you can check, name or ID also we can take. Let me take the ID. So now here checkbox selection. Checkboxes selection. Now let us see driver dot find element by dot ID. So here we need to say ID. So what is an ID? I copied here. This is my ID. Specify that ID dot. So here also we need to use click method. If it is already selected, then it will unselect. If it is not unselect, if it is unselect, then it will select. So it will work both the ways. Okay. So now this is a checkbox selection. Similarly, I want to select the one more box. Sunday is selected, and also I want to select the Saturday. Now take the ID value. So now try select driver dot find element by dot ID. Specify the value of ID, then click method. Fine. Now we selected two elements, Saturday and the Sunday. Next, what are left? So this is a upload photo. So this I will explain in the next class. And this is also calendar control. This will cover in the next class. So this is again a text box. So this we can do it. Text box, identify this. This is a basic text area. Okay, we can enter whatever text you want. Take the ID value. This is a bigger text box. The bigger text box is also called as a text area. Element text area. Now driver dot find element by dot ID. Specify the ID value here dot send case, because this is a normal text box, right? So we can enter some text value here. Now, final thing is links are there. Flight reservation or HRM. So how to identify the link? Identify this, take the link text. Here we don't have ID, we don't have name, nothing is there in the properties, right? So the only way is we need to take the link text here. Link text is this one, flight reservation. Copy this. Now I need to click on the link now. Link validation. Driver dot. So what happens here? Send, sorry, I put the quotations outside. Now come to the link. Driver dot find element dot by dot link text. Link text, okay. And here we need to specify the link text dot. Here also we need to use click method because this is a link, right? After clicking on this link, what happens? After clicking on this, what happens? It will go to the next page, right? So, but we need to come back and then click on the submit. Once you come back, this one, somehow the values will go on actually. Let me check, value still present or not. Go the next page and come back. Value still present, no problem. Okay, then after going forward, then I need to come back. If you want to come back, what is the command I need to use here? Can you tell me?
Navigate.
Right, so driver dot, what is the command? Driver dot
navigate.
Driver dot, remember, driver dot, you should tell me, you should remember this one. Manage dot, here we have written navigation commands, where this navigation method is available. So driver dot navigate dot back. Okay, so this will again come back to the main page. Now we need to click on the submit button. So where is my submit button? Go back, and this is my submit button. So identify the submit. So the ID is F submit. So copy this one and then paste it over here. So driver dot find element by dot ID, paste the value dot click.
Yeah, if we have to verify that link is present or not, then what command will write?
Right,
dot, so which display link? Right,
you're right, exactly. So if link is present or not, how we can verify? Take this value dot is displayed. It will return either true or not. Okay. Suppose if you want to put some that condition in condition, if you can put the if condition. If driver dot find element, this element is displayed is equal to true, and then do the action. This is the action. Okay.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. So this is where we can put it. So then once it is done the action, then it will go back to the back and then click on the submit button. So this is how we need to do the entire form automation. So whatever elements are left on the page, I'll cover that part in the next class. Okay, how to upload this calendar, and then also we'll discuss a web table. Okay, now let me execute this and show you. Run as Java application. Entered all the values, done. Now it should come back. Now submit, right? Then you need to verify this message. Then only the completion validation is completed, right? This message you want to verify. So how we can verify this message? So very simple. How we can verify that message displayed here, right? Thank you. This message you should get. So how we can do this? We can capture this one. Xpath of this.
Yes. Xpath.
Okay. After clicking on submit, you will see this one, right? You need to get this value. So thank you is a text value, H1. Nothing is there, just as a text is there. So how we can verify this? Take the Xpath directly. Okay, Xpath directly. Then go here, verification. After submit, you need to validate. You
can also verify the title of the page, right?
Yes, if the title of the page is different, page that is fine. Yes, and if you see the page source, it should display the title of the page. But I think so the form And whatever form we have seen, okay, successful submission. Oh, right. So this we can validate, title of the page, if it is present, or else we can take the text path of that message on the page. We can validate any way we want. So now let us title of the page also we can verify. So driver dot get title, driver dot get title equal to this one. Okay, then my test is passed. Put that into condition. If driver dot get title is equal to this one, title is this one, should not put the semicolon here. I can say system dot out dot println test is passed. Done. So this is a complete text now. So now execute once again. Okay, now let us check. So okay, so the condition is not met actually. So that is what navigate back. What is the false here?
Title may be different.
Right. So it prints as a false. What is the false actually? I am checking it now back. It is printed as a false, right? So here I am printing anywhere. What is false? Why it is
last if condition, I think.
Get dot title is equal to this one. And then
this one is false, that's why it is not printed.
It's not printed, but it is printed as a false at the end. So what is that I am verifying actually? Let me execute one second and see. Executing stuff and then go here, come back, clicking on the link, fine. Now see the output. 4. What is 4 here? 4 means number of elements in the drop down box. Right, so now we come here, see the output, get options. I'm printing this is written as a 4, and somewhere it is written false. Where it is written we need to find. So here I think so, find element. Yeah, false is nothing but that checkbox is unselected.
Okay, yeah, that was unselected.
That is false. So after that, everything is done, but the condition is not met here. Somehow the title is different for that particular page. Let me check once again. Go to this particular page. And first, let us get the title of this particular page, what it is giving. Okay. So, by ID. So this is a URL, right? So one second, let me check again. View page source of this successful submission form set. So instead of this, what you can do is we can take the partial text and check. Maybe some spaces are different. Instead of this get title equal to, I can use dot contains. I'll specify the partial value because there are some spaces required. Maybe this is present. Okay, driver dot get title dot contains, it returns either true or false. So if it is true, and then print the test is passed. Driver dot get title dot contains successful submission after this. Okay, now let us see. Right, so now it is passed. Maybe the spaces and different actually. Okay, so this is how we can do the validation. Is it clear, both of you, from the beginning to end, end to end? Not clear about any statement, just ask me now. I can clarify you. Okay. I'll give you assignment on this. It is also contain the same thing. If you go here home page, skip sign in here. I'll give you this one, registration form. Okay, this is a link actually. This is an assignment. Assignment. This is the registration form. Okay, if you go here, you can see lot many elements, same. Text boxes, address is text box, email is text box, phone number is text box, gender, hobbies you need to select it, languages and skills, and then countries. Okay, country you need to select, and here select a country. You can select multiple countries actually. One, two, so at a time you can select one country. So this is also one kind of drop down you need to check. And this is the date of birth. So there is no calendar control here, just it is at both three or a drop downs. So you need to create three different selects objects. This is different element, this is different element, this is different element, and the password and confirm password. Okay, got it. So this is a form. So after doing this, just don't submit, just refresh it. Okay, if it refreshing, then
okay.
And here we have one more option, file upload again. We need to choose the file and all. This I'll explain next class, okay? I'll tell you upload, how to upload auto IT, then you can do this exercise. Fine?
Okay.
So, as an assignment. Okay. Now, I'll stop class for today here. So, if you have any questions, I'll clarify you. So, or else you can drop. And Varshita, you asked about the tabs, right? How to select the tabs. So, you can share your screen. Or else I'll show you a small example, then you can understand. Is it fine?
Okay, you can show. Yes.
Okay, I'll show you some example, how to select the tabs. I'll show you one application, Orange HRM demo, just a moment. Okay, this is my application. Not this. Right, so open this application. Here the login is admin. So this is very complex application, real-time project application. So here you can do a lot of things, all kinds of different things you will get here. So admin A is a capital letter, and admin password A is a small letter. Login. Anyone can use this application. This is completely open source. Okay, now here we have multiple tabs here. I want to click on admin, then I want to click on user management, then I want to click on users. Okay.
Okay.
Is this a scenario you're telling about this one, Varshita? Is it the same?
No, actually,
it's different.
No, I have different one, but I have different tabs to verify.
This is the tab.
So I have menu and sub menu. Yes. Yes,
these are the tabs. Actually, we can navigate from one menu to one menu. This is possible. And you are having the different options, I think, right? So different sub menu or something like that.
Yes, sub menu also. Yes,
sub-menu. Okay, so then I'll show you one more thing. We'll take one more example. For example, I have a web page or website. Let me show you. Just a moment. Here I have, okay, so I have one web page here. This is my web page. So here I have a menu called courses. Under this, there are menu options are there. Okay, so I can click on this. I can select one options here, whichever option I want. So this is also one kind of selection. So this is a drop down. This is not drop. This is a sub menu actually. So when I click on this, when I put the cursor here, when I click here, you will get this. Actually, this is a mouse over action we need to do, but all applications are not like this actually. So this is just put the mouse over, then it will appear. But sometimes what happens, until unless we click here, submenu will not open. So your example comes under which case? This is the case or it is different? Can you show me one? Actually,
I want to see. Yeah, I can. So, yeah, I will show.
Okay, you. I'll give the control.